So, first of all, can I ask your reaction to the Premier's decision to stand down?
A little surprised, I must admit. He did say he was going to see out the term. On the other hand, not overly surprised, simply because I know that year after year, as leader of a state, a political party does take its toll. And I always say that somewhere between 7 and 9 years is the optimum period for a person to serve in a leadership position. You either achieve your goals, in which case you should hand over responsibility, or you don't, and then you certainly should hand it over. So Daniel's been there for 9 years, so he's at the extremity of my preferred optimum time. So to that extent, I'm not surprised. I think you get to a stage where there's a lot of repetition in what you do. You feel as though you're public property, you can't go anywhere without being talked to or a photograph taken or some abuse. So in terms of relationships with family, no, I'm not surprised.
Jeff, I wanted to ask you about Daniel Andrews' legacy. He's been Premier for 9 years now. Looking back at his achievements in that space of time, how will it be remembered, do you think?
Well, I think that is the real question. And I don't think we can answer that question, frankly and precisely today. This is going to be about legacy, as has been attached to no other Premier in a long, long time, because, as you were saying, he was so much in control. He didn't use the traditional media, he used social media. He controlled his party very, very strongly. But the real test is not where you start, but it's where you finish. And the state in which you leave the community, in this case as a politician, or as a businessman, or as a sporting field. So Daniel's legacy will not be determined today or tomorrow. It'll be determined over the next 3 or 4 years and might be determined over the next 20 years.
Well, Jeff, now, I'm not suggesting you're going soft. I mean, that's not part of your DNA, but you appear to be going a little soft, because I remember speaking with you on 3AW probably 2 years ago, and I asked that same question that Dougal asked you, and I said, what will his legacy be? And you said nothing. You said nothing.
Sorry, I can't remember saying that, and it doesn't sound like me to have said that. I think I would have been a lot more precise. Mm. What I am saying today, and you might be correct, I am going a bit soft today, because I do understand, I'm one of the few people, not like you guys, with due respect, I understand the honour of serving as a Premier. I understand the controls, the pressure, the scrutiny that is put upon you. So I don't want to today, within an hour or two of Daniel announcing his retirement, give you my view of all the strengths and weaknesses of his period in office. I think we've got to at least wait a little longer, because I think the legacy is going to become apparent very, very quickly. And I don't think it will be nothing. I think it will be the opposite of nothing. It'll be something. And I'm not sure how that is going to impact upon all of us, particularly we Victorians.
I get the sense, Jeffrey, in all honesty, there seems to be almost like this ex-premier's club where you do have almost like a mourning period, you know, whereby it's just respect for a few days and then the gloves are off.
And I think that's nice. Mm. Every now and then in this society, when you have a look at the words being used in the debate over this referendum, where so much vitriol, if I'm coming across to you as being a little soft-hearted, then I don't mind that today. I know his wife, Catherine, she and I have worked together for 8 years. I haven't always agreed with things that Daniel have done, but we've always spoken politely to each other. So today, I'm being polite.
Jeff, you know this better than anyone, but being in that role for such a long period of time, how taxing is it on you, especially if you've got a family on the outside you don't see very much? The Premier spoke about this today, saying you've got to be 100% committed. Is that something that you can relate to?
Yes, absolutely. And I think Daniel's wife, Catherine, was more political than my wife, who didn't enjoy my political service very much at all. But it is testing, and it's testing on the children. So it does come with a hell of a responsibility. So we've seen in Western Australia, the Premier there retired mid-term. Most of us wait until we're defeated, which is not the best way to go. So there is value in accepting what Daniel has said today as to the reasons. So we've got to take those reasons in good faith. As I said, I think the legacy is the issue that is going to colour, good or bad, his 9 years in office. And the legacy will either be a good legacy or it'll be less good. But that's going to become apparent very, very quickly.
Can I ask, did you see some of, you know, for all your opposition to Daniel Andrews, both in a political nature and maybe in a personal nature, I don't know, did you see similarities between yourself and Daniel Andrews in the way that you governed? Because when you decided, when you had a thought in your head, you just thought, right, I'm getting behind the wheel of the bulldozer and I'm going to get rid of those two towers there where now Federation Square is, right? You would bulldoze your policies through. And in many ways, your government was a one-man band. Now, which I know is disrespectful to the Alan Stockdales of this world. No, 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 but that was the perception. Did you see similarities between yourself and Daniel Andrews?
Yes, in part. In part, I never controlled my party in the way that he controlled his. We were a lot more consultative group of men and women and working well with the public service. I know what we had to do. He thinks he knows what he had to do. The real test is, I think, and the great difference was understanding, from our point of view, that a government is there to provide fundamental services, and they are the services of housing, education, good health, law and order, and that's a priority. You might be doing other things as well, but if that, as has occurred, ramps up considerable debt, well, that is where he and I would differ in terms of the way in which we administered the state.
Jeff, I wanted to ask you, this presents as a massive opportunity for the opposition. What does the Liberal Party need to do now? What does John Pesutto need to do now to gain some traction?
Well, it's still 3 and a bit years away from a state election, so there's a lot of work to be done. He's first of all got to put a team around him that will be able to manage the inheritance that he and his colleagues might be given in 3 years' time. And that is a challenge like no other group of men and women have had at state level anywhere in Australia. So he's got to assemble a team of people who have the experience to deal with what they'll be inheriting. Secondly, he needs to make sure that he takes time to develop policies that are relevant to the community 3 years from now. Now, that doesn't mean he's got to announce policies today or next week or next year, but there is no doubt in my mind, and you've heard so many commentators say in the past, and I think it's going to apply to the federal election as well, which will be held in the next 18 months, the overriding consideration of the voters, young and mature, will be cost of living. It's the economy, stupid. That will decide the election. Oppositions won't win, governments run the risk of losing. And that has always been the case in politics.
Would you concede that this is the greatest opportunity for the state Liberals to regroup and reassess? Because, as I said before, the greatest obstacle to them regaining power in this state has just removed himself.
In one sense, but not totally. As I just said, I think by the time the next elections come, federal and state, it'll be about the state of the economy. Won't be all these other issues that get thrown about the whole time. There is nothing the Liberal Party can do right now, today, that will guarantee they will win in 3 years' time. They've got a lot of work to do. I've talked about getting the resources, manpower, together in order to confront what they might inherit. But today gives John Pesutto an opportunity to focus on the things that matter, and I hope his colleagues do that, understanding that they were not elected to serve self-interest, they were elected to serve the community's interest. And the community wants a good government. They need a good opposition to keep a good government honest.
And John Pesciuto has had a lot of distractions. He's always said that reform within the party takes time. How long does John Pesciuto have when those distractions keep bubbling away?
Oh, well, I think the reality is that technically he's got 3 and a bit years, but you'd like to think within the next 12 months the party is in a solid position. They've started to identify some very good people to offer themselves for pre-selection. Some of those that are perhaps over the hill and have served a long time might give him the opportunity to bring people into the parliament before the next election. Again, as I say, today is not about the Liberal Party, today is not about the Labor Party, it's about the retirement of a Premier who has exerted his will over the last 9 years as he saw fit, almost unfettered from within and unfettered from without. I wish him well, I wish his family well, and as you said earlier, maybe I'm going soft, but every now and then it's nice just to salute the fact that an individual has served for a period of time in what is one of the most honourable jobs in the country.
And given we're seeing this new softer side of Jeffrey Kennett, I'm curious as to what you would actually say to him when you do bump into him and put your hand out.
I would wish him well.
And that'd be it?
Well, it depends how long he was there standing in front of me, I suppose. He's been to my man cave in the past. Maybe I'll invite him round for a whiskey in a week or two's time.
Like that.
On what basis was he in your man cave?
He was having a whiskey.
Well, how long ago was that?
He came... A while ago, I must admit. But while he's been leader, you've got to understand in life there's a... we're all in the same profession. It's like you guys in the... the media, you're competitive, you're looking at ratings the whole time, but you're normally polite to each other. And politicians are normally polite to each other. Nothing wrong with that. That's good.
Jeff, I just wanted to ask you...
I've gone soft.
That's what it is.
My word,
it's different face here.